think part of it is the adventure of exploration and the unknown. The idea that we're out here getting data where scientists usually can't go, and providing them with just enough data that they can come back and explore areas of the deep sea that are relatively inaccessible. But of course, the team is what makes it. We have a really diverse team as far as backgrounds and even experience levels, and that makes just being out here a lot of fun.
We don't get many opportunities to come out to remote areas like this. We're talking about several days transit from the nearest port. Any sort of data we can collect is immensely valuable, and it won't just be used now or in the next few years. It'll be used for hundreds of years, most likely. And that's really important, that we do a good job in characterizing and asking the questions to characterize these communities.
The animals that we see in the environments that I study are dependent on, are influenced by the environment that surrounds them. So we have to understand the chemistry, the geochemistry, the geology, the physical oceanography, etc. So it's important to stay up to speed with math and science, and really you have to keep studying, find something that you're passionate about. And once you figure out what you're passionate about, I think the rest is easy.
You have to understand why you're doing what you're doing. And so know the engineering, but you need to be fundamentally curious about the science, right? Because you want to find out not just what the scientists know, but why they want to know it. You know, robotics for robotics' sake is not making strides in oceanography now. It's robotics integrated with oceanography is making strides.
Have a hypothesis to test, or if you want to collect a type of sample in an area that's being explored, you know, maybe you just need some initial results and just have an idea that something is there to be able to go down and have an actual look at an area that you have some ideas about, or in this case, to take these samples.
We put these push cores on the ROV, and they have these nice little handles on. And so we stick it in to get this profile of the sediment. And then once it comes up, we do a couple of things to it. We look at the sediment chemistry, and that can tell us what kind of animals might hypothetically live there. And then we actually sort through the sediment to see what animals are there.
I think exploration is a critical dimension of science. It's easy to get caught up in thinking that science requires that you have a hypothesis. In other words, you say, I believe these fish eat A, B, and C, and you go out and test it. And that is really the best way to do science and to kind of robustly understand what that organism is doing. But if we don't do exploration, then we're missing out on discovering those things that we don't know, right? There's no other way to do it. And so it is incredibly beneficial to advancing science because we see and learn new things.
There are limited numbers of berths on any research vessel, and by allowing people to tune in via the internet, we can get more scientific minds watching and contributing information on every single dive, so we can get better IDs of geological and biological features and try to collect organisms or geology that someone might need for their own research and get their opinions and help them in their own projects, which we wouldn't be able to do just by lack of berths otherwise.
You know, you look at the best scientists and they have so many different strengths and so many of their own individual weaknesses that it really takes all of us as a team to advance our understanding of science, and that's how it gets done.